Let's go!
After all the jibes, after all the barbs, they're finally showing down. Number four versus number three. Woo!
Brooks came in firing heavy and fast. Immediately gets the takedown, looks at him locking up the legs. He's got one hook in. Let's see what he chooses to do with it. Doesn't quite need the second hook.
Don't forget, folks, check out our Year of the Tiger merchandise. That's available now through One Dot Shop.
Good job,
Brooks.
Has
the back of Minowa here early on. An aggressive opening from the American, as he vowed he would have.
He's got control of the hips now with his legs. Minowa's trying to flatten himself out, gets back into the guard. Good job by Minowa to retain and maintain that guard position. This is where Brooks is dominant, though. Brooks has got heavy ground and pound. He works the body, and then he starts to go up to the head. Dominant ground and pound from the monkey guy.
Brooks will look to posture up here, rain down those hammer fist strikes and those elbows on Hiroba Minowa. There's a crossing elbow, breaks it across the orbital.
It looked like Minowa felt that, too. It looks like he's doing those tests of strength every single time he throws a ground and pound. You know those things where you hit the hammer on the mallet?
Oh, those tests of strength.
That's what he's trying to do, man. He's like, the way he uses his posture and the way he puts everything into those hammer fists. Look at that. Boom, crushing elbow.
I thought you were talking about Festivus for a moment, Dragon. Feet on hips here from Minowa. Inside the guard, closes the guard, opens it up again, the Japanese warrior. Mixing it up with both hands with the ground and pound is Brooks.
I think he's already cut him, Michael. Look at that, one of those thunderous elbows. Jared Brooks is intense right now.
Brooks called out Minowa the moment he beat Leto Adawa. And he's been going back and forth online against the champion, Joshua Pascio, who he says he wants next should he beat. Well, he says he will beat Minowa tonight.
Yeah, this is a problem in the strawweight division right here.
Look, that's a problem cut, Dragon, because that cut is right above the eye, and already Minowa is blinking heavy. Got to watch the blood doesn't run into Minowa's eye and impair his vision.
The Detroit representative, that is Jared Brooks, can keep this pace and this intensity for the entire 15 minutes. He is a savage on top. Minowa has got to work his way out of this. He's got to try to get those feet on the hips, start pushing. He's got to have some urgency. If he does not, he is going to get smashed on for this opening stanza.
Minowa promised he would not allow Brooks to get under his skin. Brooks again trying to load up with that left.
That is
Lances
educated.
Quickly towards his corner.
That is educated ground and pound, Michael. The way that you can see, Minowa tries to reach down to control the wrist, and immediately Brooks comes over the top with a massive elbow.
Trying to posture up and drop the right elbow on that occasion. Jared Brooks, he has messed up the face of Minowa early. There's another sharp right hand. From inside the closed guard. Heightens that guard a little more now, does Minowa. What does Minowa need to do here, Mitch?
Well, he's trying to create an angle here. You can see him sliding his hips out of the side. He's not just keeping his guard closed. Typically what you'll see a lot of athletes do is they'll close their guard and just kind of hold on to the guy. That's not what Minowa wants to do right now. He needs to create space and create angles. He's trying to take that right leg of his and get underneath so he can create a sweep. But Brooks, highly educated grappler. Look at the way Brooks keeps adjusting his hips and his angles so that Minowa is not able to get his feet into a proper position to create a sweep or a scramble.
Minowa wipes the blood from his forehead. He is in trouble early on here, Hiroba Minowa, with 1 minute remaining in the first round, set for three. A fight that both men promised would not go the full 15 minutes. Another cracking elbow, this time to the left cheek of Minowa. And there's a popping left hand to the right cheek of the Japanese warrior.
Yeah, it is demoralizing to be on the bottom like this and just getting smashed on. Everything you try to do gets shut down. Every angle that he tries to create, see, he tries to pop his leg underneath the leg to create that sweep, but Jared Brooks shuts that down and gets right back on top. Brooks is a high-level wrestler, ladies and gentlemen. He's an Indiana State wrestling champion. He wrestled out there at Notre Dame. This guy is a beast on the ground. We're seeing exactly that right now.
Total and utter dominance in the opening 5 minutes from the monkey god from the USA, Jared Brooks.
He's going to try to pull him away from the wall here and continue to beat on him. Oh, he hit him with a knee.
A knee and an elbow. Brooks trying to finish in the closing seconds to choke him out.
Stop.
What a round. What 5 minutes to open the fight from Jared Brooks, the monkey guy controlling all.
Michael, Brooks hit Minowa with a jumpy knee when he was on the ground. Oh, good golly, Miss Molly. Look at this. This is how he opened the round. Immediately, look at that. Touched him with that right hand. Minowa goes, okay, I'm going to grapple. Shoots down, gets the leg, and then the rest of the entire round was all Brooks. Look at this right hand. Boom, rattles the jaw of Minowa. But then all Brooks, the entire rest of that first round, dominant ground and pound coming from Brooks.
You hear me? I could be more proud of you, brother. Sharp, man.
That final elbow you saw in the replay was the one that cut Minowa open, and the corner are loving everything they are seeing. It is monkey madness from Jared Brooks. Utter dominance.
Okay.
Into the sixth minute.
Let's
go. For 15. Can Brooks find a finish? Can Minowa find a way back into this match? High kick from Jared. Minowa with the inside leg kick. Jared faking the cross, then throws it and backs him off with it.
Good straight line weapon right down the middle. Touched Minowa with that straight right hand. He keeps that pressure on. Good head movement, bobbing in and out.
Overhand right was telegraphed from Minowa. Can he get his strikes off here? Protect that winning streak. He comes in with 6 wins in a row. Hiroba Minowa. Brooks calling him forward, trying to get Minowa to come on the inside, but also get inside Minowa's head. Attack him psychologically as well as physically.
Minowa looks nice and relaxed on the feet still. I like how he threw that knee up the middle, just to give Brooks an idea that these straight line weapons, if you drop your head down to shoot him for a takedown, I'm gonna hit you with one of these knees or these uppercuts. But Brooks catches the kick. Beautiful transition into a takedown.
Let's see what striking looking sharp, Mitch.
Yeah, but it's also his just total aggressiveness. You know, he's just got a whole nother level of intensity about him.
He's like the strawweight John Lineker. Just its total intensity and aggression from the opening bell.
Yeah, if John Lineker was a grappler, it would be Jared Brooks. But look at that, ground and pound. Very educated ground
and
pound.
Let's go.
Chooses his shots very carefully, doesn't flurry unnecessarily, gets positioned first, and then chooses to do damage.
It's that educated ground and pound you mentioned in the opening round, Mitch.
Yeah. You know, he's not really trying to pass the guard of Minowa. I think he respects the guard of, you know, Minowa, and Minowa's doing a good job of keeping his feet in front of Brooks. But this is what I think we're going to start to see as the minutes tick on. Brooks is going to keep doing damage, keep kind of elevating his attacks, and then he's going to start to look to pass the guard of Minowa and then look for probably, you know, maybe a head and arm choke, you know, some sort of finish.
Goes to half guard. Does Jared Brooks gets to side control now. The American. Minowa turns, gives his back. Brooks has got it now.
That was nice. Good little pass. Gets into side control. Minowa chooses to give up the back. And
is this it for Minowa?
This could be a wrap. No, actually, no, I think he's on the side. Minowa might be able to get out of this, but it looks like he's underneath the neck. It's a bad spot for Minowa to be in. That's not good.
Is it going to be Joshua Pascio next for Jared Brooks? Can he sink this sub? No, Minowa survives. And the crowd loves the resilience of the Japanese athlete.
Not
knees
quite the
to the
angle.
Head of a grounded opponent.
Not quite the angle that Minowa needed, or Brooks needed, to sink in that choke.
Watch for the back of the head, okay? If you need.
Here's that
watch
head,
for the back of the head.
Front headlock control coming from Jared Brooks as he's utilizing those knees. Man, he loves this rule set. Knees to the grounded opponent. Look at him.
Those knees are legal, and they are glorious for Jared the Monkey God Brooks, gaining control with 1:35 remaining in the second round.
Minowa's trying to go underneath the leg there, but that's going to kind of limit his defensive opportunities. Jared Brooks shut that down immediately. Now he's going back. It's the Monkey God ground and pound right now. Look at that, driving his head into the chin of Minowa, and then just creates a little bit of space. Boom, hits him. Goes back to the position. Secures the position, and then goes back. Yep, look at that.
So how does Hiroba get out of this predicament?
Right here. See, he's got to get his back against the wall and work his way back up, right? But look, Brooks is controlling the hips. He's got his hands locked. He keeps pulling the hips away. Now he's going to triangle the legs. Bad spot for Minowa to be in. He needs to push on the head, slide one of those legs out, and work his way up while he's got his back against the wall.
45 seconds remains in this round. Minowa's corner barking instructions at him. What a torrid contest it's been so far for the number four ranked Hiroba Minowa. What a way to kick off one championship, only the brave. Minowa posts up on that right arm, trying to work his way up the fence and get back to his feet, as Mitch said.
Good job by Minowa to get his legs out from underneath the legs of Brooks, but this is what Brooks does. He's got his hands locked. Minowa needs to create separation on those hands. Otherwise, he's going to be fighting a losing battle by trying to work his way back up. If he can't separate that grip, he needs to push on the head and really start to create a scramble. Minowa is such a good scrambler, but the grappling of Brooks is just so difficult to deal with.
We are going into the deep waters of the third round, and admittedly, both men didn't think we'd get this far. Another super aggressive 5 minutes from Jared Brooks.
Look at this. Minowa was able to create the angle to get out of that rear naked choke, work his way back up, but Brooks was still just so dominant.
We're not gonna end it here. Come on, let's do it. Feel it. This is not the end. You cannot end here.
It's nothing technical. In the corner of Minowa, it's all about raising his spirit, digging deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude to somehow turn the tide against the dominating monkey god, Jared Brooks, who opens up like a house on fire again, Dragon, and boom, shakalaka.
Wow, Brooks just comes right out of the gate, firing the punches right into the takedown. Look at this, once he gets those hands together.
He said he plants him like a tree, put him through the canvas. He is trying at the start of the third and final round.
Beautiful job, and he takes him away from his corner, which is where he was to begin that sequence, takes him right back into the middle, and it's really smart because he could have took him to his other corner, right? To his own corner, but that would have put him up against the wall. Brooks chose to plant him in the middle of the circle so there was no wall to try to work his way back up from. That's very high level mixed martial arts right there. And Minowa was the one saying he had more mixed martial arts knowledge.
Look how lumped up. Look how lumped up the forehead is of Minowa. Looks like he's growing horns as Jared Brooks inside the guard continues to dominate, pops that right hand.
Good guard. Just maintenance from Hiroba Minowa. He's able to keep his legs in the front of Brooks's body. You know, Brooks is having a hard time passing the guard of Minowa. He's got a really good back, but that's kind of his thing. He gives up his back. Brooks latches on, drives him up against the wall. Let's see what Minowa can do here. He's got to have some urgency. He's got 3 minutes to really make something happen. He's got to get the finish because the ground control has been all in the way of the blue corner. Brooks is looking for that finish. He's got his hands locked. He's going to try to suck him away, turn him off the corner so his back's not against the wall anymore.
Say a big hello to Joshua Pascio, the champion, watching this one at Team Lakai headquarters in Baguio City in the Philippines. Because if Brooks wins here, you know he wants Pascio next. You know he wants a tilt at the goal. Okay?
I know Sangyao is all over this matchup, watching this very detailed to be like, what weaknesses does Brooks have that we can possibly exploit? Look at, oh, good job. See, again, Minowa was going for a choke, trying to get a submission, but Brooks was able to flatten him out and get back on top. Good, but still, Minowa was able to maintain the guard.
Can Minowa find a way back to his feet with 2 minutes 30 remaining in this third and final round? A grimace there from Minowa, maybe taking a moment to get some air in his lungs. He's breathing heavy here.
Man, Brooks has not had his hands separated for very long at all. If his hands are separated, he's punching Minowa in the face. His hands are always clasped together. Minowa needs to do something about his hands and separate that grip. But, man, with the decades of wrestling experience that Brooks has, his grip has got to be like a vice, Michael.
Still to come tonight, folks, the final four of the ONE Super Series Featherweight Kickboxing World Grand Prix. Sudachai, David Kuria, Smokin' Joe Nutterwatt, and Chingiz Elazov in our double main event.
You know, I'm so impressed with Brooks's grappling because, you know, we saw Minowa against Alex Silva, and, you know, Minowa was able to control a lot of that matchup and win, you know, a grappling contest.
Let's go,
Brooks is just a different type of grappler. Look at him. Got his hands locked. Steps over to the side, trying to triangle those legs again. Minowa's probably going to be able to slide one leg out, right? You can see him trying to get one of those legs out between the legs of Jared Brooks. Yep, there he goes.
Minowa has got to find a way to swing this back in his favor. As Mitch said, he'll need to finish Jared Brooks.
No holding,
if it goes to the judges, we both believe that Brooks will get the nod. It's been dominant from the American, and Minowa's got just over a minute left.
1 minute left
in
the final round. Let's go, 1 minute left.
Let's finish, let's go.
I'll tell you what, Joshua Pasho's watching this, and Pasho brings in a whole different challenge level for Jared Brooks' Dragon, should that fight happen, because Brooks has never fought anyone with the wushu striking caliber of Joshua Pasho.
Brooks has fought a lot of people. Maybe not the wushu style that you speak of.
And the wushu style is very awkward.
You know,
and it's worked for all the Team Lakai guys. So many world champions they produced.
True, but Brooks has been in there against some of the top tier athletes in the world, Michael. So he, this is what.
Oh no! That one went south.
Yep. Neutral corner.
20 seconds to go, and
he's gonna say no contest.
I think it's done for Minowa. Oh, that's not nice. There will be allowed 5 minutes injury recovery time here for Hiroba Minowa, or the duration of a round, but he's not in a good.
But you got to manage your weapons, Michael. You can't, you know, he's this far ahead, this close to the end of the match.
Yeah, that's not deliberate, Dragon. He's trying to go for the upper, it looks like the upper right thigh.
100%, I know it's not deliberate. It's a complete mistake.
It sounded like you were criticizing him. It was nothing malicious, you know?
What?
So Jared Brooks will stay there while Minowa tries to recover. And like you said, 20 seconds remaining. But this one might be done now.
Nah, I don't think Minowa's going to go out like that. I think he's going to shake it off. He's got 20 seconds to go. He's a warrior.
Oh, yes, he is. The crowd appreciate it. Comes up and down and tries to shake everything back into place. Hiroba Minowa. 20 seconds to try and figure out something to slap on Jared Brooks.
His best option is going to be like one of a front choke.
Tell me, Dre, you have 20 seconds. What do you do? What do you go for?
He's got to go for it. You know, you expect, you know, Jared Brooks is still going to look for the finish. He's still going to try to go forward. Maybe Minowa could catch him coming in with something, flying knee, big right hand.
What would you go for?
Maybe a front choke.
What would you go for?
I would against ready Brooks, maybe jump off the cage, hit him with a showtime kick. Look at it.
Minowa's ready.
Ready? Let's go.
Like Daniel LaRusso's going to fight. Hiroba Minowa's got 20 seconds to find some jumping knee. That's what he goes for. You're called a Dragon. And that might be the last salvo for Hiroba Minowa. 10 seconds now. Another jumping knee. He tapped it under the chin. But it wasn't enough. And Brooks fires forward. Minowa swings. The aggression comes too late from Hiroba Minowa.
Good job, gentlemen. Good job.
Great sportsmanship there, though. After all the trash talk, it's the respect, the Budo martial arts spirit, integrity and honor between two martial arts warriors.
Lives up to the hype, Michael. That was a good match. That was a masterclass put on by Jared Brooks, though.
Is he about to call out Joshua Pasho? Guess we'll find out soon. Have a look at the big boom shakalaka here. There was the first one. And then a second. Trying to put that arm out to break the fall a little there. At closing seconds, the final flurry after the jumping knee from Minowa. A hook and a round kick and a back fist there from Jared Brooks. Crazy stuff. What a way to launch our card tonight. We are going down to the judges in our first match on Only the Brave. And wherever you're watching, folks, we hope you're enjoying it just as much as us. Let's go now to Dom Lau and find out our winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Jared!